You'll notice a lot of options when you add a new quiz to Moodle, but really there are only four sections that you need to pay attention to for the vast majority of the quizzes you create. The first is the general section, where you'll add the name and the description. The description is optional, but it gives you a chance to provide any additional instructions you may want the students to see before they take the quiz. The next section is the timing section. This gives you the option to control when the quiz is available to students and potentially how long they have to take that quiz. By default, these settings are unchecked, but I strongly recommend checking them to enable at least an open and close time for your quiz. The reason for this is some instructors hide the quiz itself within Moodle, and that also hides the corresponding grade in the gradebook. That can be really confusing for students. Instead, you can use the open and close time for the quiz to control when the students are able to open the quiz and attempt to take it. Now, if the open and close times are meant to be the only time that the students can take the quiz, then you don't really need a time limit. But if you're keeping the quiz open for several hours, or even a couple of days, you may want to add a time limit if you want the students to complete it within a specified period of time once they start. The next section to take a look at would be question behavior, and I strongly recommend changing shuffle within questions from no to yes. What this does is it shuffles the order of the responses within multiple choice or matching questions so that when they display for the students, they're always in a different order, even if they attempt the same quiz multiple times and see the same questions. This saves you from having to do it yourself in the question creation. The last section, and the section that controls quite a few questions that we get in terms of support, would be review options. And review options controls what the students see at what phase of the quiz. Obviously, there's during the attempt, there's immediately after the attempt, there's later while the quiz is open but they've completed an attempt, that's assuming you use the open and close times, and then after the quiz is closed. In other words, what can the students see for the exam after the close date occurs? If you don't add a close time, you will not see some of these settings available for you to choose, although they may appear to be checked. They won't be available to students unless you actually check the open and close times further up this page. If you don't want the students to be able to see the attempt after the fact, you would just uncheck the attempt and they would only see how they did on the quiz. Again, some of these look like they're checked, but since they are grayed out, that means that the students will not see those things. Because I uncheck the attempt, they can't see whether it's correct because they can't see the actual questions themselves.